He's had media training, Owain.
True. Self-training.
Or should I say, Owain?
You fancy yourself for that one, don't you?
I'd put my banter up there. Again, the other one would obviously have to be Leeds Rumble.
It's got to be Leeds Rumble.
Just in general, just to look at him, he was a funny character, wasn't he? He just didn't look normal.
Truns was the one who, you know, any situation, he'd make light of it, wouldn't he? Do you know what I mean? Yeah. Like, Monks used to think that he was the funniest in the dressing room. Not a chance, man.
We had a couple. Angel, Rangel for me.
I think I'm too perfect. Hold on.
I go the little fella, the little rat, Leon. He just, for quality, like the boxes. I don't think he ever gave the ball away in the boxes. Yeah. It was annoying. Yeah, but always Roberto. If we had the heart rate monitors, for me as a midfielder, he'd always show me Leon's stats. He'd say, hey Owain, Leon has got to this. I'm thinking, stop comparing me to Leon.
Roberto must have been Scottish. For what's just come out
that's
of his mouth.
That's a good accent, there. That's a good Roberto.
Roberto was a good trainer as well, wasn't he? But he was intense. At certain times, he used to carry a note.
A notepad, yeah.
A notepad in his sock, and he used to take it out and take notes, which used to baffle me. Obviously, you see where he's gone to now, so it worked.
Thank you.
Best dress. Definitely weren't him.
What?
It weren't him.
Look at them Hugo Boss trainers then.
I know. Anything look good next to him, though?
Hugo Ross?
Yeah. The Manchester market, these. Best dressed.
Like, Truns would fancy himself as best dressed, no chance. He wouldn't be scared to try something, would he?
He'd probably have to say Truns, wouldn't you?
He would.
He'll love that. And he deserved that. He kept top man in business. He did, didn't he? He's got to be up there.
What?
He has. Honestly. He's up. Where'd you get clothes like that?
High and mighty. Are you forgetting before Christmas party, Leon wearing that green cardigan?
Yeah.
Can you remember that?
No.
Like, fluorescent green, like the face of the match.
I just think you're deflecting off yourself.
Oh my God, he's here. Wow, the temper on this man, like training, games, half time, after the games, you're like, you couldn't shut him up. I'm thinking, where's the mute button here?
Yeah.
You won't stop.
There's no mute button on this one, let me tell you.
You know, and you'll give it the story of, you know, it's for inspiration, you know, to get the dressing room going. It's like, nah, mate. The lads are just looking at you thinking,
he's answered his own question.
Here he goes again.
He's answered his own question. Biggest moaner for me.
Willie Gray.
In his own way, Willie was up there as a moaner. Monks was a little bit of a moaner as well in his own individual way. So I'd say Monks, mate.
Intelligent.
Yeah, he would be up there.
I'm up there, aren't I? Yeah, but you class me as intelligent because I can read.
And you're from Bangor. They're all intelligent up them ways.
Sam Ricketts?
Sam would have to.
Sam would be the guy that you'd look at.
He's intelligent, but he'd put a glass eye to sleep.
Oh, bless those Wrexham players in the dressing room now.
For me, it's an easy one. That's Paul Connor. He was trigger, wasn't he?
Yeah.
He wasn't
the brightest.
He went easy on the eye. He just looked stupid.
Do you know who I'd go?
But he said stupid things as well.
I'd say Tate as well, though. Like the story of him cooking pizza on a hob.
Yeah.
Because he thought the hobs were just specifically made for pizzas. And he obviously burnt the bottom of it. That's not the brightest, is it?
Possibly. I've actually done things like that myself, so you could probably class me in that bracket.
I'll put you in. Okay. No problem.
Was that just a cooking problem?
That's dumb.
For me, Paul Connor is the at least intelligent by mine.
It's got to be...
You're going to say me?
No.
1,000,000%, you're going to say me.
Why? What do you say?
I am up there. Things can only get better.
I was going to say trans.
We need the Daffy Walker here.
I was going to say trans.
No, he fancied himself. No. He's squeaky voice.
I think he pulls it out of the bag.
I reckon, no. Honestly, if I'm going to be completely honest, I'd say the best singer was myself.
I'd go Roberto, you know.
Yeah,
Like Roberto never drank alcohol, but he'd be the one on the dance floor. Everyone's looking on, thinking, and he must be steaming.
I don't know what I'm doing here, but I'm doing the same thing. He used to do that with his shoulder, didn't he? But off on me.
And he'd say, Don't fight it.
Yeah,
music gets into you. Just let it happen.
Yeah. And he had them brown loafers on as well, didn't he?
Oh, they never came off. Then.
No.
I'm going to go with the big man, big Kevin Austin.
Yeah.
You know, the old stories that we used to have a laugh about, saying Kevin Austin once shielded the ball out of play from the halfway line.
He shielded me out from play.
Mate, he was just
when he played
strong.
For Bristol. Yeah, he
strong
was.
Strong man.
Physically strong specimen, wasn't he?
Obviously, Big Bayo then comes into the mix.
Yeah. What do you define as a hard man, though?
You're desperate to put yourself
I'm not putting myself in at all. I was an angry man, an angry little man.
You're not there, mate. You're
okay.
A million miles off.
We'll just end it there, Kev Austin. Same again. He had a song after him. So, Kev, yeah.
Big Kev.
Big Kev, million miles.
No brainer.
Yeah, million miles. I was way off. Way, way down the pecking order.